Okay, team, Operation Find the Lost Treasure of the Backyard is a go! Maya, is the perimeter secure?
All clear, Captain Leo. No squirrels in sight. I've got the official treasure digging shovel ready for action!
Are you guys sure about this? My mum said the only treasure in this backyard is her prize-winning petunias. If we dig up a petunia, it's not Operation Find Treasure, it's Operation We're All Grounded.
Don't worry, Sam. I have a map. See? X marks the spot, right between the big oak tree and the squeaky garden gnome.
Let me see that map! It looks like you drew it 2 minutes ago with a crayon.
It's an ancient crayon. Now, let's dig.
I'm on it! Dig, dig, dig! Wait, I hit something.
Is it a treasure chest filled with gold or maybe chocolate? I hope it's chocolate.
It's not a chest. It's hard, like a rock.
Let me see. Wow, move your shovel.
It's just a boring gray rock, the worst treasure ever.
I told you guys, petunias and rocks, that's all we're going to find. Can we go get snacks now?
Wait a minute. Listen, do you guys hear that?
Hear what? I just hear Mr. Henderson's lawnmower next door.
And my stomach rumbling. It's a very loud rumble.
No, listen closer. It's like a humming sound. It's coming from the rock.
Whoa, you're right. It's humming. And feel it. It's a little warm.
A warm, humming rock? That's not normal. What if it's an egg? A dinosaur egg? Or an alien egg? What if it hatches right now? I don't want to be a dad to a baby alien.
It's not an egg, Sam. It's perfectly smooth. And look, when I cover it with my hands, it glows.
It's glowing! This is the coolest rock in the entire world! This is way better than gold!
Glowing and humming is definitely alien. We should put it back, gently, and then run away, very fast.
No way! We're not running away. We're scientists, and this is a discovery. We need to take it to the lab for analysis.
To the garage. Let's go.
You guys call it a lab. I call it a garage with a very wobbly table. Okay, I'm coming, but if a three-eyed space lizard pops out, I'm blaming you.
Okay, the specimen is secure. Welcome to the laboratory.
So what do we do first, Professor Leo?
First, we observe. It's gray, very smooth and oval-shaped. It has a low, steady hum and a faint internal glow that gets brighter in the dark.
Observation, it's creepy. Hypothesis, we are all in big trouble.
Let's begin the experiments. Test number one, magnetism. Maya, hand me the super-powered fridge magnet.
One super magnet coming right up.
Now, let's see if the magnetic field has any effect on the specimen. I'm moving it closer. Closer.
Is it going to explode? I feel like it's going to explode.
Nothing. The magnet doesn't stick to it at all. It's not magnetic.
Aw, man. Okay, my turn, my test. Let's see if it's super strong. Let me try to break it with this hammer.
No, Maya, no. We don't smash mysterious objects in the lab. That's rule number one.
Yeah, what if you make it angry? I don't want to fight an angry glowing rock.
Fine. But we have to do something exciting.
Okay, how about this? Test number two. The water displacement test.
What's that? Does it involve water and displacing because it sounds complicated?
We're just going to see if it floats. I'll fill this bucket with water. Carefully. Okay. Ready?
Ready! Let's see this thing swim!
Okay, I'm lowering the rock into the water. And it sinks. Straight to the bottom.
Well, that was not very exciting. Can we agree that it's just a weird rock and my stomach's hypothesis is that it's time for lunch?
Wait, look at it in the water. The water makes the surface clearer. I think there's a pattern on it.
Let me see. Pull it out. He's right. Look at these faint zigzag lines all over it. They look like little lightning bolts.
Alien lightning bolts. This is how they communicate. It's probably saying, take me to your leader. And I am definitely not the leader. He is.
Lightning bolts. Zigzags. It reminds me of something I saw in my book. My favorite book, Rocks and Minerals of the World. Be right back.
He really loves that book. Do you think it will tell us what it is?
I hope it has a chapter called Humming Alien Rocks and How to Politely Ask Them to Leave.
I found it. Look at this page.
It's called a geode. What's a geode?
It says here that a geode is a special kind of rock that looks plain and boring on the outside, but it's hollow and filled with beautiful crystals on the inside.
Crystals? You mean like sparkly, shiny treasure? Real treasure?
Exactly. It says the outside is a very hard rock, which is why the hammer wouldn't have been a good idea, Maya. The only way to see the crystals is to carefully crack it open.
So there's a secret treasure hidden inside this boring gray rock? We have to open it right now!
But what if the book is wrong? What if it's not crystals inside? What if it's alien goo?
There's only one way to find out, but we need to do it safely. We'll need an adult for this part. And safety goggles. Let's go ask my dad for help.
Yes, let's go. Operation Crack the Geode is a go.
Okay, I'm in. But if it's goo, we are never speaking of this again.
Okay, Dad helped us. He used his big hammer and tapped it just right. Are you guys ready for the big reveal?
I can't wait. Open it.
I'm closing my eyes, just in case. Tell me if it's goo.
Here we go. Whoa!
Oh my gosh! It's beautiful!
Is it goo? I'm peeking. Whoa! It's not goo at all. It's like a cave full of purple diamonds.
It's amethyst, a type of quartz crystal. Look how it all sparkles in the light.
It's amazing to think this was hidden inside a plain old rock the whole time.
It's the best treasure we've ever found. It's way better than chocolate. Well, maybe just as good as chocolate.
See? It just goes to show you. You can't always tell what's on the inside just by looking at the outside.
We are the best treasure hunters in the world!
And the best scientists. Hey, wait a minute.
What is it, Sam? Are you worried the crystals are too sparkly?
No, it's not that. Listen, the humming, it's stopped. And it's not glowing anymore either.
He's right. It's quiet now. And dark. Why did it stop?
A new mystery. Let me think. My hypothesis is that the pressure inside the hollow rock was causing vibrations, creating the humming sound. And maybe that same energy was making the crystals inside glow. When we cracked it open, we released the pressure and the energy.
So the magic escaped? Like a genie out of a bottle? That's so cool!
Or the tiny alien pilot that was flying the rock spaceship escaped. And now he's invisible and probably hiding under the lawnmower.
I don't think it was magic or an alien, guys. It was probably just science. Let's get a closer look. Hand me the official lab magnifying glass.
One magnifying glass coming right up!
Okay, let's examine the crystal structure. See how they have these flat sides and sharp points? That's how the molecules of amethyst line up. They build on each other perfectly, like tiny purple building blocks.
They look like tiny little castles. Can we do anything with them? Can they shoot lasers?
Please don't shoot lasers in the garage.
No lasers, but my book says amethyst is the birthstone for February. And that, for thousands of years, people thought the stone had special properties, like keeping people calm.
Calm? I like calm. Let me hold a piece. I am feeling very calm. The calm is flowing through me. Is it working? Do I look calmer?
You look exactly the same, Sam, but the purple is a nice color on you.
We need to give our discovery a proper home. We can't just leave it on the wobbly table.
Let's build a fortress for it. A treasure fortress! We can use these old boxes and make walls and a moat.
A moat? We'll get the floor all wet. We should just hide it again. Dig an even deeper hole this time. No one will ever find it. Not even us.
No. A true scientist displays their findings for further study. We should build a museum exhibit.
A museum! Yes! With a light and everything to make it sparkle?
As long as there's no moat.
Deal. Okay, Sam, you find a good strong box. The shoebox my new sneakers came in should work. Maya, you can be in charge of making it look good. Find some of that black cloth my mom uses for sewing. It'll make the crystals pop.
I'll make it the most glamorous rock box ever. I'm going to add some glitter, too.
Here's the box. Are you sure about glitter? It gets everywhere, for weeks.
Okay, team, let's assemble. Place the black cloth inside the box, gently. Now, carefully arrange the two halves of the geode so they look like a little cave. Perfect. Now for the lighting. Hand me that flashlight.
Look at it shine! It's like a tiny, sparkly galaxy. It's missing something, though. Aha! Glitter!
No, Maya, not the glitter. It's a scientific exhibit, not a birthday card.
A little bit of glitter is okay for flair, I guess. Okay, last thing. Every museum exhibit needs a label. I'll write one. Geode, specimen 001. Discovered by the backyard exploration team. Contains amethyst crystals.
It's perfect! Our very first museum exhibit!
It does look pretty cool. I'm not as worried anymore. It's actually kind of peaceful.
Let's just stand back and admire our work. Shh.
It's so quiet and pretty.
It is. Except for one thing.
What?
Do you guys still hear that humming sound?
Hey, yeah, I do. It's very quiet, but it's still there.
But how? The geode is open. It's not vibrating. My hypothesis was wrong.
The alien. It got out of the rock, and now it's humming from its hiding spot. We have an invisible humming alien in the garage.
Let's find it. I'm not scared of any space creature. Okay, alien, come out. Come out wherever you are.
Hold on, hold on. A good scientist doesn't jump to conclusions. If the sound isn't coming from the rock, it must be coming from somewhere else. Let's use our ears. Everyone point to where you think the sound is loudest.
I think it's over here, by the recycling bin.
No, it's definitely over here, by my dad's smelly fishing boots.
I think it's coming from that corner, behind those old paint cans. Let's play hot and cold. I'll walk towards the corner. Tell me if the sound gets louder.
Okay, you're getting warmer. Warmer.
So warm. You're practically boiling. You're on fire.
It's definitely loudest right here. Let me move these cans. They're heavy. What is this thing?
What is it? Is it an alien communicator?
Is it an alien egg warmer?
It's a little black box plugged into the wall with a stake on the end. And it's vibrating. I remember now. My dad bought this last week. It's a sonic mole chaser. It sends a vibration and a humming sound through the ground to scare moles away from the garden.
A mole chaser? So the humming, it was never the rock?
It was a mole chaser this whole time? We thought we had a humming alien space rock, but we really just had a regular rock and a gadget to scare fuzzy little animals?
Exactly. The sound was traveling through the ground and we were right on top of it, so we thought it was coming from the rock we found.
Wow, I guess we were wrong.
And that's okay. We made a hypothesis and it was wrong, so we investigated more and we found the real answer. That's exactly how science works. And the best part is, even if the humming wasn't from the rock,
we still found an amazing, incredible, super sparkly treasure.
And we did it together. We're the best backyard exploration team ever.
We sure are. Now, who wants to help me write a new museum label for the mole chaser?
Me.
Me. And then can we get snacks? All this science is making me hungry.
It's a deal. Operation Find Snacks is a go.